Hello, this is Kevin Schoessow with the University of Wisconsin-Madison Extension, and I'm out in the university's teaching and display garden here at the Spooner Agricultural Research Station in northwestern Wisconsin. So this is a Zone 3 growing region, and I'm standing in front of a cold, hardy wine variety called, I'm not sure what this is called, Minnesota 1200, I believe. But this particular variety of wine grape is being trained on vertical shoot positioning, and this is in the spring prior to any kind of spring pruning. We won't have to do a lot of training on this particular plant at this time of the growing season. That's done mostly when the shoots are developing, and we call that vertical shoot positioning. So we'll train all these shoots to go in the upright position. So this is what was left from last year's growing season, and this is the kinds of materials and the canes that need to be pruned out. So I'm going to go ahead and demonstrate that, but just wanted to give you a preview on what this plant looked like prior to pruning. It's probably about a five-year-old plant. We've got the trunk. Actually, there's two of them. One trunk comes up and goes to the right, and you get a cord on, and the other one goes to the left onto the bottom catch wire for the lower cord on. And then from the cordon, we have these renewal spurs that provide us the fruiting canes for our fruit that is going to be positioned in the vertical upright through these catch wires. So I'm going to go ahead and do a little pruning, and we'll show you how this looks when we're all done. One of the things I appreciate with the vertical shoot positioning when it comes to spring pruning or late winter, early spring pruning is the first cuts to remove all of last year's old canes is fairly simple. So in this case, everything that's above this bottom catch wire is one-year-old fruit wood, for the most part, that is above this bottom wire. So we want to just come in here, and we can make pruning cuts anywhere about 6 or so inches above that bottom wire. So you can just go in here and just start snipping off, making that long pruning cuts just to kind of get rid of everything on top. So all I'm doing is like giving this a haircut. It's like a buzz cut. So we're cutting everything back to about this middle catch wire. So anything above the middle catch wire gets cut off. So this you can do pretty indiscriminately, fairly fast, because you don't have to do a lot of counting or thinking at this point. So now we just need to go in here and physically remove all of those canes, and makes it a lot easier to see what we're doing. So already you can see it's a lot less to look at. I'm always amazed at how these tendrils attach themselves to everything, man. That's what makes a grape a grape. Tendrils, long shoots, lots of vegetative growth. Okay, so basically I've just given this a haircut right across these middle catch wires. And that's our starting point. All right. So now from here, we have to decide what to keep and what not to keep. Okay, I've kind of refocused the camera here to just show the left cordon of this vertical shoot positioning grape plant. So I went ahead and I cut everything, all the canes that were above this catch wire. So I kind of gave it a haircut. We've got all these remaining short fruiting canes left, and we've got to thin this out and prune this back to the proper number of fruiting spurs and total number of buds. So there's a lot of decisions to be made here. And the first one that I'm going to make is this particular cordon goes way off in this direction, kind of is curved down and it's interfering with the adjoining plant that's behind me. So I'm going to just go ahead and shorten this cordon up back to where it probably should be. So just like carpentry, they say measure twice, cut once. So I like to start with just removing what I know needs to come out, and then I can decide how much more I want to cut it back. So I'm just taking it incrementally as I go, just reevaluating, making sure my cuts are, I'm comfortable with making those cuts. So again, I'm going to cut this again. So I've gotten rid of that downward swooping cordon that was here. So you can kind of see how that looks now. But now we've got all kinds of potential really nice looking canes that are, right now I've got them cut to about 8 buds, and we typically on vertical shoot positioning leave between 3 and 5 buds for per fruiting spur. So we call them a spur because they're less than 10 buds. If they're greater than 10 buds, we call it a cane, like we did in the forearm Niffen. There we use 10 or more buds on a cane, so that's cane pruning. This is more the spur pruning. So we're gonna cut these all back to 3 to 5 buds and then try to space them so that they're literally like 5 to 6 inches apart or thereabout. So we've got way too much happening with these. So I'm gonna just start thinning these out again, taking out the thinnest, least productive looking spurs fruiting spurs that are left. So I'm gonna just keep kind of whittling away here. And the process I'm thinking about right now is diameter of the cane or that's left and position. So again, we can always cut them long to 1 or 2 buds if we don't want to cut them all the way back. But in some cases, we can make that decision and cut them way back. So I'm actually going to get rid of this one. There's too many. So we got four of them all jammed in here. And I always look at the attachment points. And so I am going to get rid of this one. I'm also going to get rid of this one. I'm going to spur that, just leave it with a few buds on there. Maybe I'll get a replacement spur for next year. The taller up they are is another decision-making option. So on this particular cluster, this cane is sitting up high. The one next to it is a little lower in its position on the plant, so I'm going to go ahead and cut that one out. Again, I always leave them spurred initially and then I can come back and clean them up later. So here's a fruiting spur right here. We still got to eliminate one of these. And I guess I'm going to go with I'm going to probably take out this one right here. I'm going to take it out right like that. Okay, so now we got to count number of buds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So I'm going to spur them to about 4 buds. Then we move on down here. We don't have quite as many options, and these are further up. We really don't have, except for these two here, we don't have any fruiting spurs, not like we did here. So there's 2 small fruiting spurs. These are really not going to be very productive. They're too small. I'm going to cut them back to 1 or so buds. Maybe we can get some replacement material to come in here for next year. Again, these are not very fruitful looking to me. This one here is. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. All right, this is another one that's, I'm going to just cut that right off right here. And this is actually coming from over here. I'm going to just cut that little shorter just to get it out of the way. All right, for fruit spurs here, again, I look at the position. We got a really nice one in the back. It's a little beat up, but it's getting kind of high. So I'm going to cut that one out because we've got two other ones. Again, I'm going to cut these back to like one bud. Maybe they'll give us a replacement spur for next year. And it's just, this is pretty looking pretty weak too. This was a replacement trunk, another one of those suckers that was left just in case we had some winter injury on these, but all these look really good, so I'm going to take this out. Like I said, you just got to be careful when you extract it. So this is the left side, and this is kind of how I'm going to leave it. We've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, about 7 fruiting canes. Some are a little better than others that we left on this cordon. And we've also renewal spurred some of these short to 1 or maybe 2 buds, and hopefully we get some replacement shoots. So during the growing season, as these buds break, we're going to tuck them in behind these catch wires and again train those sprouts to go straight up in a vertical fashion. That's why they call this vertical shoot positioning. And here too, I've kind of given it a haircut and rough pruned it up to about the middle catch wire. Now we need to go through this process of eliminating the fruiting canes that we don't want, because we got to get this down to about at least half as many of these fruit spurs on this side of the plant. So again, I'm always looking to remove fruiting spurs that are up high, especially if we've got another one that's right next to it that's down lower. So I'm going to start down here on this end and just do that. So again, I'm removing these fruiting spurs that are 3 to 4 buds long, and this one was up higher, and we want to keep everything concentrated as close to the cordon as we can. So that's the reason I cut that one off. There's another one here that's up high. Can't see it, it's behind the post, but I'm going to cut that one off. All right. So again, fruiting spur that we don't need. This one here is kind of up high. I'm going to go ahead and cut it off. It's a beautiful piece of fruiting wood, but we got others here we can go with. So now I'm just kind of pruning these back to 5 or so. I'm going to spur this to 1 bud. Same with this one over here. Maybe we can get some replacements off of that. Here's 2. One is higher, one's lower. I always cut out the higher one. Here's one that's going off into the side. I'll just cut that off and leave 1 bud. So already you can see how I've cleaned that up. There's still a little bit more going on here than we need. This one is kind of growing up in a weird angle, so I'm going to go ahead and take that one off. All right, so I'm going to leave that the way that is right now. Now we've got some more decisions to make. It looks like there's a replacement cordon that was put in here. Not sure what to do with that right now. This is on the underside. We don't want that. This one is up high. Again, we want the lower one. Here's another one that's up high. Keep the lower one. Another one that's up high. So that's my first decision, is the position on this renewal spur. All right, so we got 3 of them all coming off together here. One of them's got to go. I'm going to just take the middle one. And then, like I said, just clean this stuff up and maybe we can get another bud to break. So on the back side here, we've got, yeah, I think I'm going to take this one out because it's crossing this one. This one here is angling out. This one is pretty weak. I'm going to take that back right to there. Just take that off. In fact, I'm going to go all the way back to here. Then I'll do that. So it is what it is. You take what you got. So I'm just counting buds here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the total number of buds is greatly diminished. I'm going to just leave that for now. This is kind of a dead spot, so I trained a replacement cordon through here. So this one isn't very thick. I'm going to go back to about 2 buds. There's another one on the back side here that's spindly. I'm going to cut that down to 1. So we don't have a lot of good fruiting spurs in through here. Again, all these little short ones, I'm going to just prune back to 1 bud for right now. I'm going to do 1 bud on this. But here we have a nice fruiting spur that's coming off of this cordon. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we got another one that's on the back side here. I'm going to cut that to only 3 just to keep our bud count where it needs to be. We're looking at, on vertical shoot positioning, they say anywhere between 30 and maybe 50 buds per cordon on each side. I always tend to leave a few more just to have a little insurance as long as the plant's vigorous enough. So I'm going to keep just kind of cutting these short. They're too thin diameter to really keep as fruit wood, but we'll spur them and maybe we'll get a renewal bud to break and give us some nice options next year. Okay, now we're just getting back to this here. This one is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm going to cut it off right here. This one's getting a little tall. So when they get that tall, I like to just head them back a little bit. Same with this one, it's reaching up too tall. So I'm gonna just knock those back a bud. So this would be kind of my final pruning on this VSP, both the left and right cordon. All right, this is the finished vertical shoot position final prune on this Minnesota 1200 wine grape. So we've got actually 2 trunks, one going to the left, one going to the right. This is a common practice we do here at the Spooner Ag Research Station because we sometimes can lose a trunk from cold injury, and it's just nice to maybe have 2 separate trunks rather than 1. So this is our final length on our fruiting spurs. They're between 3 and 5 buds. Some of these fruiting spurs are getting to be a little bit high, getting a little further away from the cordon than I care to, but this is what the plant gave us, so this is what we did. So this is again vertical shoot positioning on a Minnesota 1200 wine grape.